سلام بینندگان و شنوندگان عزیز، امروز شنبه سوم مارچ 212 برابر با 13 اسفند 1390 با سلام و درود فراوان دوباره به همه تمامی شما، تک تک شما که ما را نگاه میکنید و میشنوید. از آقای سوربی تشکر میکنم که این برنامه رو با این وسیله ها رو بر اختیار ما گذاشته تا بتونیم خدمت رو به هموطنان عزیز و کسایی که معلول هستن یا احتیاج به این تکنولوژی دارن در اختیارشون بذاریم. من با آقای کامران رسول که خودشون معرفی میکنه این برنامه ویژه برای نابینایان و ناشنوایان را شروع میکنیم. از آقای کامران میخوام که خودشون معرفی کنن. Come on, go ahead and introduce yourself, why you are here and what are we going to be doing and what's the reason you are having this.
Assalam, I'd like to first thank Modern TV for inviting us back again. So some of you know us, this is our third show here, and so if you're coming back to see us again, welcome. And if it's those of you new to the show, welcome as well. Again, thank Modern TV for having us again. Today's show, well, my name is Kamran Rasool, as Safar has said. I'm an AT specialist or assistive technology specialist. I work at a university here in Washington, D.C., called American University. Safar has invited me kindly to speak about adaptive technology to help individuals with disability. And for today's show, we're going to be talking about several things. First, we'll talk about cane technology and how that can help individuals with low vision and blind. And we're going to start with showing how cane for children who are learning how to use cane, and then how technology advances for when they get older. Second thing we're going to talk about for the hard of hearing and the deaf, the CapTel telephone that we have purchased, and we're going to talk about how bone captioning works and how it can benefit somebody with hard of hearing and deaf. Third thing we're going to talk about is Dragon Naturally Speaking, that can serve the learning disability community as well as for those who may have physical limitations. And is a dictation software that allows individuals to speak to the computer. This is something that we mentioned in our last show that we're going to have for today's show, so we're probably going to have that. And the fourth and the last thing we're going to talk about is ZoomText, which is a software that allows somebody with low vision to access the computer visually to see it easier on their eyes, so they don't have to strain as much or have difficulty difficulty seeing the screen. From there we will take any questions and answers after those sessions.
همونطوری که آقای کامران به انگلیسی صحبت کردند، به طور فشرده ما این برنامه را با از کسانی که از کین استفاده میکنن و برای اولین بار که ایشون بچه‌هایی که میتونن استفاده کنن اینا برای اولین بار برای مبتدی بودن این برنامه میرن چه کار میکنن، به اونا رو از کین استفاده میکنن و یادشون میدن که چطوری با کین راه برن و جهت رو پیدا کنن. بعدش همینطوری که ما داریم این ویدیو رو نشون میدیم، تلفن ها رو باز میکنیم، اگه کسی سوال داره صحبت میکنیم، سوال میگیریم، اگه کسی سوال چیزی داره درباره سافرا و برنامه‌ها میتونیم بیشتر شرح بدیم. فعلا تلفن ها بازن، اگه دوست داشته باشه کسی زنگ بزنه میتونه زنگ بزنه.
تلفن یا
تلفن the video, we're going to show the video first, then we open the telephone to if somebody wants to come.
Tap tap tap, slide 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 your cane, slide 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 your cane. Good job. Who, Dora? She'll be here in a little bit. You know that this is the last thing you do. You usually have me, then you go home tomorrow, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Slide, slide, slide your cane. Side, side. Side, side. Can I see you slide it side to side? There you go. Side to side. Side to side. Good job. Side to side. Ooh, hey, there's the wall. Pay attention. There you go. Good job. Side to side. Oh, I love it. Good job. Good job. Are you video any of this? Are you doing it already? Oh, cool. Side, oh.
Oh, great. You can hear me singing on it too, huh? Side to side, side to side. All right, can you turn left? Good girl. Come to me. This way. Left, left, left. There you go. Straight. No, left. This way. That's the cafeteria. Come here. Hannah. Hannah. This way. You hear it? You're listening, aren't you? Come here. Turn left. Come on. Keep going. Let's see if we can find the door. See if we can find the door with your cane. Come on. Can Mr. Cane find the door?
He's gonna look for it.
Come on. Let's go outside. What are you listening to? Come on. Let's go outside. I know you're listening to that. I wish I could tell you what it is. I don't know what it is myself. I hear something humming in there. All right. Find that door. All right, ready? 1, 2, 3, push! Push! Okay, push! Good! Find the mat! Good! Yeah, I know you don't want to walk on the mat for something. All right, find the next door! Good! We're gonna push!
Okay, the purpose of showing that video was to demonstrate that a cane is a type of assistive technology. It's not a high-tech technology, an example of a low-tech technology, meaning that it's a technology that doesn't require any computer support. But we wanted to show a child, for example, who's a pediatric child who is blind and learning how to use a cane at a very young age. It's a very nice example. And by the way, the video is not. We should let you know that it's not a video that we recorded. The video that was provided on YouTube, and we can provide you a link to that video if you want to look at it again. But it just definitely demonstrates how you can use something like a cane, which is an example of a low tech. And a child is using that. And as in the next video we're going to show, the second video will demonstrate how somebody who is, I guess, older and using a technology applied to their cane.
Yeah, همونطوری که کامران تعریف کردن این از عصایی که داره بچه استفاده میکنه همون کسی که مسئول این آموزشگاه هستش که اینا رو برای به طور برای اولیه اینا رو بهشون یاد میدن اینو خیلی تکنولوژی پایین هستش یعنی تکنولوژی اولیه هستش اول باید یاد بگیرن که با عصا یاد بگیرن با از عصا استفاده کنن بعدش ما داریم ویدیوی بعدی رو که نشون میدیم یه تکنولوژی جدیده که میتونن با راهنمایی از یکم بزرگتر که میشن از این تکنولوژی میتونن استفاده کنن از ویدیو داریم استفاده میکنیم و تکنولوژی جدیدیه و به اینا به وسیله صحبت کردن این دستگاه و تکنولوژی اینا رو راهنمایی میکنه کجا برن و این ویدیو رو الان نشون میدیم و میتونی شما نگاه
tap 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 slide 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 your cane slide 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 your cane good job who Laura she'll be here in a little bit
as this user comes within range of the base her activator begins to vibrate and beep letting her know that she is near a source of information that can direct her to her destination. Pressing the button triggers a pre-recorded message at the nearby base.
Welcome to the Garden City Mall.
Confident, she can now begin her shopping experience. Additional bases are placed strategically throughout the mall to guide the user to important locations. Here, the user is approaching an ATM machine in order to withdraw cash. As she nears the machine, her activator picks up the signal from the base unit. Pressing the first button, she triggers the recorded message.
ATM machine.
Pressing the second button, she gets a more detailed recording.
If you need assistance, please call 232-4467.
Having bases installed at vital locations throughout the building brings independence and convenience to the user's shopping experience, helping her to find and navigate the escalator and to independently reach the public restrooms. Finally, when it's time to go, the StepHere system guides the user safely to the elevator for an easy departure.
Elevator.
With StepHere, daily life for persons with disabilities becomes simpler, easier, and more enjoyable. The StepHere navigation system, guiding your way.
اسم این دستگاه استپیر استش. این یه دستگاه گیرنده است، یه دستگاه فریستنده است. معمولا دستگاه گیرندهش خیلی کوچکه، میتونه رو آدم های بزرگتر معمولا اینو میتونن داشته باشن. جاهایی قرار میگیره که تو اینا، این کسایی که نابینا هستن، مثل کتابونه ها، مثل مترو، اینا رو چه کار میکنن؟ دستگاه فرستنده رو اونجا سوار میکنن و این از قبلا میتونی پروگرامش بکنی. جاهایی که مثلا حساس هستن، مثلا هر معمولا هر 15 متری یکی از این سنسوران میذارن. این وقتی که شما این دستگاه گیرنده رو فشار میدی، اون چیز میکنه، اون به دستگاه فرستنده اشاره میفرسته و بعد این فرکانس رو میگیره و راهنمایی میکنه که مثلا اینجا بانک، اینجا متروه. و خودتون که میبینید همینطوری که ویدیو میگه، قشنگ این کسی که میخواد جایی که میخواد بره قبلا راهنماییش میکنه و خیلی راحت به اونجا میرسه. آقای کامران، you can say whatever.
I just want to say that, you know, one of the reasons we want to show the two videos.
One of the videos
that we showed earlier of the pediatric child using the cane, then we showed this new video with somebody using additional technology to guide them. Even this, some of you who are not able to see this, the video itself, the person using the cane is obviously knows how to use a cane. They know how to navigate around the community. So we wanted to show the basic fundamental of how to use a cane. That doesn't change. How to navigate around using a cane did not change. So the second video is to demonstrate how we can use additional technology, adaptive technology, if you want to call this this device that the video demonstrating, is to assist somebody who's using the cane to navigate better and easier in, around the community. So we certainly don't want to show that a pediatric child cannot use it. It's just they need to learn how to use a cane first, and then the technology can help them further in getting better navigate.
بخش بعدی میشه یک تلفنی هستش که برای ناشنوایان استفاده میشه، کپتلت میشه. همینجا سوارش کردیم دفعه قبل که همین جلسه رو داشتیم، قول داده بودیم که بیاریم، فقط ویدیو اینو نشون دادیم. امروز تلفن رو آورده بودیم، اگه کسی دوست داره زنگ بزنه، قشنگ ما میشنویم و میبینیم که هم میشنویم هم میبینیم که شما چی میگید. میتونید تلفن کنید و اینو تستش میتونیم بکنیم. اگه یه نفر دوست داشته باشه میدونه به این تلفن زنگ بزنه، در حالی که شما زنگ میزنید صحبت میکنید، هم ما میتونیم ببینیم هم شما میتونید بشنوید. آره، اگر آقای سوربی زحمت بکشن این فیلمو بذارن و شما میتونید اصلا زنگ بزنید خود با لایف، یعنی به طور زنده ما این تلفن رو
کپچر. اگر
It's a lifesaver for somebody who's hard of hearing.
تلفنی هست که ما داریم و اگر کسی دوست داشته باشه پیام بخواد زنگ بزنه.
And at that time I was just crying all over to people that I hadn't been able to talk to before.
I enjoy answering the phone now. I don't shy away from that.
Somebody's calling.
Before I went back to answer.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, you're online.
Oh, that's great. It seems like the CapTel is working right now.
Yeah, that's nice. I wish If this one goes ahead, then you know, Madam TV can even have this option for the people who does not have you know, hearing.
Is the text showing up on the screen right
yes,
now?
All of, yes, all of yes, all of them. Whatever you say is capture it and is nice. And this caption now it works in Spanish and English, but it can be in Farsi. But we don't have the permission to do it. And so this is good, and we can just use it. Or if somebody wants to call, then we can answer it. And that's the way.
Well, one of the other features of the capital phone, you can actually you can turn on or off the caption feature by pressing the caption button on or off. So if you don't necessarily want the caption. But you can hear, because this has a fairly loud amplified speaker on it. A speaker on the headset. It does not have a speaker set. On the headset, it's fairly loud, so you can turn on and off the caption. The other feature you can do is you can actually access the customer support. If you ever run into problems, customer support is 24 hours, 7 days a week. We'll also provide a link to the Capital website. The person who's on the phone, they can actually hang up now. I'm going to hang up on the phone right now. Thank you. It also has a volume. You can actually adjust the volume. You can make the volume completely low, low as you need it to be, or you can make it fairly high. And it's very high. It gets really, really high. And if you're using a hearing aid that has T-coil, for those who understand that terminology, those with hearing aid with T-coil, it'll amplify the sound much louder than that. You can have three numbers on speed dial. You can, so family, friends, or emergency, you can put them on a three-number speed dial option. As Safar said, it does read in Spanish. If you live in a community or you're in contact with an individual who speaks Spanish frequently, it does caption in Spanish. This phone is available it's available in the U.S. It's approximately $100. It can take calls from Canada and other parts of the world, but it's always best to call the company to be sure that this is the phone will work for what you need it for. Other than that, it's got large buttons, so somebody possibly with low vision, an older adult, can access the phone fairly easy. Very simple, it doesn't have a lot of complicated buttons or switches.
They can simply Google the name Captel. They can send us email, we send them information.
Sure, yeah.
Let them know we are not selling them, we are not...
No, exactly.
From selling them.
Right. We're, if anything, we're just demonstrating the product. We're not selling the product. We're, say again, you know, if you type in Captel, we can attach a link to that below the video. In addition to that, you can also attach, again, for those who are hearing it, a loop mic. You can also attach a microphone with a headset on it to give you more clarity for those who are hearing you. So the Capital service is free, so there are no additional charges for the service. So you just purchase a phone, call them, let them know that you give them your serial number.
There's no monthly charge.
And there's no monthly charge. It's all provided the federal regulated services. You need to have Ethernet connection, a high-speed Ethernet connection. And you need a phone jack, a landline, or in this case we're using Magic Jack, which works just as well. So so it's easy. We set it up within 5 minutes. So you connect the Ethernet cable, make sure the Ethernet connect. It is not wireless. Maybe the next version it is. Yeah. This is 800i version. It is not wireless. You need to have an Ethernet cable connected directly, and a telephone landline, and a power. It needs power source, so you need to connect it to a wall plug. And simple as that. You could take it anywhere. You could travel with it and connect it anywhere in the U.S. You cannot connect it outside of the U.S. So if you travel into another country, it will not work. But you can receive calls from another country. But please call the company and make sure that the country that you wish to communicate with, that they can support it. They're very good. They open 24 hours, 7 days a week. It's a great product. I'm sure there are other products out there, but this is a good one.
همونطوری که کامران شرط دادن این تلفن ساده ای هستش که کسایی که ناشنوا هستن خیلی راحت میتونن استفاده کنن. اگه کسی میتونه فقط تو چیز آمریکا میشه استفاده کرد ازش. این به این صورت هستش که یه صفحه داره وقتی کسی صحبت میکنه اینو به صورت کپشن رو میگیره و نشون میده، تکست رو نشون میده، این گفتاری که طرف صحبت میکنه رو صفحه نشونش میده و خیلی چیز ساده‌ای هستش و هم به انگلیسی هستش و هم به اسپانیش. حالا آی سوربی میتونید از قسمت دیگه نابینایان و مال چیز جی پی اس هستش که یکم هم گرونتر هم برای کسایی هستش که اسپیشال نیک دارن و میتونن اینو بخرن، میشه استفادهش کرد. این یه نوع نویگیتر یا جهتیابی جدیدی هستش که جی پی اس هستش و برای کسایی هستش که همه جا میتونن استفاده کنن. ویدیوش الان نشون میدیم و این
1994. Blind person's toolbox of alternative tools and techniques should now include an accessible GPS. Some tools are for mobility and some are for orientation.
Turn right on Singapore Lane 184.
Then the challenging part. Choosing and purchasing the appropriate tools. And then learning how to use those tools. Hey, are we having fun yet? Go ahead and ask yourself. Are we having fun yet? But it's best to hear about the value of location information directly from blind college students, a mobility instructor, and a retired teacher as they explore the road to independence using their GPS tools.
Hobie Wendler, student.
So the Sendero GPS technology has been extremely useful for me throughout my whole college career. I became familiar with it as a freshman here at Davis, and we're on such a large and diverse campus. I mean, there's streets, bike paths, everything in every which way. And without it, it would be very difficult. But for instance, walking out of the social sciences building or Wellman Hall or the chemistry building, I can hear how far away intersections are, how far away various points of interest are, like other buildings where I have classes. The difficult thing about asking other human beings is I think as blind folks we have different modes of understanding. Like you ask someone on the street, hey, am I heading southeast towards the Memorial Union? And they might not know or have to be as familiar with our cardinal directions, so they don't really know. They're like, well, the MU is that way, you know, and they'll point. But with the GPS, it's basically a way to visualize what's around you in a way that's very meaningful and very logical, and all the information makes perfect sense as a blind person.
Martha Pamperin, retired teacher.
I use it mainly to stay oriented on the green belt when Lainey and I, my guide dog, and I are out for a walk, because the green belt is difficult to navigate. It has these long, gentle curves that you can be changing in direction 90 degrees without my being aware of it. And it has Y intersections, and sometimes I have difficulty telling whether Lainey has selected the left arm of the Y intersection or the right one. So it's easy to get lost on these green belts, and the GPS helps me stay oriented. After I've walked a few steps, I can ask the GPS which direction I'm going, and that alone is a tremendous help. I can also set points of interest at places on the green belt that I need to find on a regular basis. It will then tell me when we reach those or as we approach them and go by them. I enjoy using it on trips as well, just to navigate for the driver. I can wander around with the GPS pretty freely and be pretty confident that I'll be able to get home again on my own.
Jesse Garcia, veteran.
Me and my bulldog, we walk to the store, come back every day for exercise. Then occasionally we get on the bus. The first time I used my GPS, Mike May was with me, and my wife was a little... I can't say hysterical, but she was extremely worried where I was at. And I called her up from Mike May's cell phone, and I told her we were at the Tower Market down the road. She asked me, how did you get there? Did you fall? Did you hurt yourself? I go, no, I had my GPS, and Mike was training me how to use it. Good. That was the very first day. I hit bus 39, that's right at the corner. I hit the bus, and then sometimes I'll set a route that'll tell me where I need to get off and what bus at that point that I need to get back on. So I have it already set for my use only. I'm able to make more decisions if I want to go someplace. I just can get up and go now without any problem with my GPS. And I've been doing it for about 3-4 years now.
Sandy Staples, mobility specialist. And Kevin Chow, student.
I've had the pleasure of teaching the Sendero Brownlow GPS for the past, oh, maybe about 3 years. It's been just a wonderful experience trying to integrate it within the natural travel for students. I found that because they knew their Braille notes and they knew how to get in and out of programs, how to problem solve using the Braille note itself, that learning to use the Sendero Braille note GPS program was a fairly simple process for them. I was able to support them as they were using it, but really my main job was helping them learn to interpret the information and match it to real-world experience, and that was actually what used my skills as an orientation and mobility specialist.
Paige Bolden, student.
Attaboy. Let's. Okay, it's finals week, and I want to go get some coffee at the closest Pete's, so I'm going to search for it in virtual mode on the PK. So I'm going to start with an advanced search with the space F.
Enter starting distance for the POI search.
Coffee within a mile.
One. Select at a party. All.
All.
All. Chosen. Enter POI search string or press enter for nearest points.
Okay, so Pete's is P-E-E-T.
Heat 2 points found. It's coffee tea 0.63 miles north.
Okay, so I'm going to set this one as my destination, which is a space D.
Destination set to Eats Coffee Tea.
So now we want to plan a route there, so I'm going to press an R.
Route commands list.
I'm going to push a P.
Creating pedestrian route. Route created.
Okay, that's easy enough. So now that I have the turns, I feel more comfortable, and I can put this route into action using my PK. Okay, right? Inside? Oh, it just said we arrived at our destination. Finally. Good job, Lance.
For more information, visit AccessibleGPS.com or SenderoGroup.com or call 888-757-6810.
بینندگان و شنوندگان امروز برنامه ما زنده است میتونید زنگ بزنید میتونید تماس بگیرید ما با این تکنولوژی رو که نشون میدیم یکم تلفن ها رو صفحه هستن و میتونید با ما تماس بگیرید این جی پی اسی که نشون دادن خوبیش اینه که فقط یه بار پرداخت میکنی و اینه که نمیدونم اگه اشتباه نکنم انواع اقسامش هست الان جدیدترش اومده یکم بهتر صحبت میکنه صداش بهتره سافر بهتری گذاشتن روش فکر میکنم اگه اشتباه نکنم $300 ولی یه تکنولوژی جدید دیگه هستش آیفون 4S سوریه که قشنگ میتونی صحبت کنی هم بهتره ولی خب شما باید اینترنت کانکشن باشی باید وصل باشی به چیز به اینترنت که بتونه این برات شما کار کنه الان میتونه کمال رسول میتونه امتحانش بکنه و قشنگ نشون میده که دایرکشن بهت میده باید صحبت میکنه راهنمایی میکنه یه اون شهاد سیریز ورک بود دیگه به جی پی اس
اون
هم
اوکی آی تینک آفتر گیوینگ می 1 سکند اوکی سو کوای جست وانتد می دمونستریت هاو سیری ورکس وذ جی پی اس So, just simply, you know, you hold on. Well, those of you who may or may not have the iPhone, the iPhone S. Can come on the screen here. It'll give us a couple of things to make sure it's not blurry for some of you.
Actually, because of the light,
as it showed you.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm just going to describe it. Okay. So, so just like the iPhone, it has a little center button in the bottom. The iPhone 4S can finally have the Siri feature, which is the voice recognition software that if you give it a command, it'll bring up tasks that you wish to do. So in this case, we're going to use the GPS. So, for example, I want to look for the closest coffee place around the area. I hold down the button, and then Siri will be activated, and I just give the command. What is the closest coffee shop?
I found a number of coffee shops fairly close to you.
Okay. And now Siri will list the coffee shop. It doesn't necessarily read it back to you. So somebody who's low vision or blind, it will not read. Now, if you have VoiceOver activated, which is the VoiceOver is a tool that is available for people who are low vision and blind, that feature will allow you to read back. But let's just assume the VoiceOver was activated. I'm going to select the closest coffee shop here. And then if VoiceOver is activated, it will tell me the name of the coffee shop. And this one is called the Oaks Cafe, which is in the Virginia area. And then I tap on that, and it will give me more details, like the phone number, the address, and here the GPS option with direction to here or from here. So in the case we want to go from this location that we're at to the location of the coffee shop, and I tap on that, and then I'll give you the option, do I want to go by car, bus, or usually bus or subway, or you want to walk there. But let's just say if I want to walk there. So I'm going to select the walk option, and then I route it, and it's calculating it for me, and there you go. Now it gives me the direction, and it tells me I can start walking, and it'll follow me along the way. They'll follow me, and it's very, very difficult to see on this camera here. There's a pin, which is green, that's me, and the red pin where I stop.
Do you want me to switch it to this one? This camera is digital.
Okay, we're going to do a switch on the camera here, so
you
give us a second.
Voiceover part? Okay.
No, we're going to turn on voiceover. Let me show them this camera, and then we'll...
So that,
so as you can see, there's a green to the look at the camera TV, it'll be to the left of you, and the red pin is to the right.
Town goes around like this.
It's your location. That's where it goes around.
Yeah, well, it is. Yeah, it goes around telling that's the closest. It is the most accessible way to get to the store. So that's the, like, watch around voiceover. Say again, bear with me. You should be able to get the same information by voice. I'm going to turn on the accessibility here.
Voice over on. Settings. Maps.
To know where I'm on. Okay.
Maps. Edit. Button. Selected. Selected. Directions. Tab. 2 of 2.
Okay. So now...
Hold it for a while.
I think I have to get away from the camera so you can hear auditorily what it's going to give me.
Selected. Directions. Tab. Selected. Directions. Tab. 2 of 2. Okay. Settings. Selected. Direction. Selected. Directions. Tab. 2 of 2. Search. Selected. Direction. Selected. Directions. Selected. Directions. Tab. 2 of 2. Selected.
Okay, I'm just trying to get out of here. Give me a second here. Okay. So,
Maps. Maps. Edit. Button. Directions by car. Tab. 1 of 3. Directions by selected. Directions by walk selected. Direction. Start. Button.
Okay, there we go. Now it's...
Forward. Tab. 2 of 2.
Okay, so now I can go ahead and tell me what streets I need to go next.
Selected. Forward. Tab. 2 of 2. Walk 0.2 miles down. Walk. Turn right onto Meadow Hunt DR.
Okay. So now it will read back to me auditorily the step-by-step direction to get to this store. I'm not going to go through the whole story. There are like the 6 steps to get there, but you get the idea. So.
Right.
Yes.
Now we can play some music and take a break, and if it's possible, we can come back.
Screen locked.
Yeah, what
we got میتونیم یه بریک بگیریم و بعدا میتونیم یه موزیک پخش کنیم و بعدا با شما خواهیم بود.
درد دوری چندی سخته، هر ستی ها میباره، مهمی رو مرکم و ترسیم و پیغوم نیاره. هر تو را دیستی چه نومه دادی یا تیم و من نگادی چندی نیبو برگشته یاری کنم یارو نیبو پیدا نوم را دیدیم و قید خوب مده اون تینو مرادمی بود درد خدایی خوشینو هری دونی دارو موچی دیله بیدا آشیده اشبه دیدو میابا و دیاری همه دولی و میبانه ای برامون بکاری
بینندگان. با تشکرات فراوان که تا حالا منتظر ما موندید و از این ساعت 4:49 است ما داریم در برنامه دیگه رو شروع میکنیم. امروز شنبه است و برابر با 3 مارس 2012 13 اسفند 1390. آقای کامران رسول دارن درباره سافر جدید که دراگن هستش و این سافر خیلی به کسایی که چیزای فیزیکی دارن میتونه کمک کنه. You want to talk about dragon? ناتوانی دارن.
Now I'm going to demonstrate Dragon Naturally Speaking Software. Dragon Naturally Speaking Software, as I told you, mentioned earlier, is for individuals who are either physically disabled, unable to access a computer using the keyboard or mouse with their hands, or to help those with learning disability who have trouble writing a paper or writing information notes with a pen or paper or even with a computer because they struggle. And by the time they get their ideas out, they lose that idea.
اوکی okay. تا حالا به این صورت بود که این نرم افزاری که الان وجود داره اسمش دراگنه و برای کسایی هستن که نمیتونن از دستاشون استفاده کنن یا مثلا از این فقط صحبت میکنن. این سافاری چه کار میکنه؟ این سافاری هستش که میتونه از طریق مایکروفون اینو متنو به گفتار یا گفتارو به متن تبدیل میکنه و این از کامپیوتر استفاده میشه و اگه میخواد ایمیل بفرسته اگه هر کاری میخواد بکنه این کامپیوتر براش انجام میده. Voice. Go on.
Okay.
Do you want me to show your screen now or not?
Yeah, you can show the screen. Yeah, that's fine.
No, this is your screen.
Right. Okay. The Dragon Naturally Speaking Software is available both on the PC and the Mac. The version that we're going to demonstrate here is the PC version, but they work very similar. The PC version has been in the market longer than the Mac version, so the Dragon quality is there's been more research and development going into it. It is Dragon Naturally Speaking Software is developed by a company called Nuance, N-A-U-N-C-E. We'll provide a link at the bottom of the video at a later point. They distribute Dragon for the Mac and for the PC. Okay, so this is Dragon version 11, premium edition. It has a very basic layout. It's got a profile list, which lists of all the individuals that are using Dragon. Dragon, if you want to call it, takes a fingerprint of your voice, so no two individuals can use the same profile. This is to prevent another person from speaking on your behalf, if you want to call it. The tools option has a Dragon pad, which is a simplified version of Microsoft Word pad. And it's got other things. I mean, it'll take a while for me to go through every feature of the Dragon software, but let me just get right into it. Okay, so it's got a microphone. We're using an external mic on our laptop here, but you can use a headphone. It'll work just as well. We don't really recommend using the web mic that's built into a lot of the computers now, which is part of the webcam feature. So we strongly encourage you to buy an external mic. Okay, so to begin with, I'm going to turn on Dragon Pad or activate that, which is part of the Dragon software. Dragon is always recommended to use in a quiet space as possible because it's trying to recognize your voice. It's not recommended to be in a noisy environment. So I'm going to activate Dragon. You can see there's a little red button here. As soon as I activate Dragon, it's going to want to hear what I'm saying. So there are a couple of commands I can give Dragon. I can say wake up, which I'm obviously not turned on now. I can say wake up, go to sleep. And a lot of correction features. I select all, delete that, punctuation, period, exclamation point, and so forth. So let me just do a very simple. I'm going to activate Dragon. Good morning. Comma, how are you? Question mark. Scratch that. Comma, how are you? Question mark, new line, go to sleep. So I just had Dragon speak to me. I'm just going to increase the size of the font here so it's easier for you to see. See if I can make it larger here again. Okay, so the purpose of going to sleep, it allows the individual to think about what they want to say, or somebody came into the room, interrupted them, a telephone call, you just want to say go to sleep. Dragon is still listening to you, but it just knows that you have other things going on. So I'm going to say, when I say wake up, it's going to wake up, and then I can talk again. Wake up. Today was sunny. Calm up, tomorrow it will be raining. Scratch that. Tomorrow it will be raining. Exclamation point. New line. I wish it would be sunny tomorrow as well. Period. Go to sleep. In addition to that, Dragon also has the ability to correct sentences, words, as you see I corrected that as well. But I can also do a spelling check. So, particularly when you have a unique name or place that is not recognized by Dragon, you could train it. And then when you train that, it'll recognize that after you train it. You can do other things like you can bold, italicize, underline. Wake up. Select today was sunny. Italicize that. Go to sleep. So you can do a lot of things with the voice. And in addition to that, you can actually navigate your entire computer with Dragon naturally speaking. You don't actually, it's not restricted to using for word processing. You can actually tell Dragon to Google a Japanese restaurant in the neighborhood and it'll do it. So it's really powerful. In a nutshell, that's Dragon. There's a lot more I can talk about. Hopefully if some of you call in or email us, if you want more, if you want us to do like a more detailed show about Dragon, we can do that.
همونطوری که کامران صحبت کردن این دراگن برنامه ساخت نرم افزاری هستش که به طور خودکار یعنی به طوری که اصلا بدون اینکه از دست و از چیزهای دیگه استفاده کنی میتونه راهنماییت بکنه مهمش اینه که هر که این دراگن این نرم افزار رو باید هر کسی ویس خودش رو باید رو اون تمرین کنه که این نرم افزار بتونه اینو ریکورد کنه که بشناسه یعنی صدای شما رو میشناسه که کسی دیگه نیاد از صدای شما بتونه استفاده کنه و مثلا ایمیل بفرسته یا کار دیگه بکنه این نرم افزار طوریه که شما تمام هر کاری میخوای انجام میده مثلا میتونی بری گوگل سرچ انجام میشه برات هر تمام میتونی تا هر همون کاری که یه آدم عادی انجام میده یه آدمی هستش که یکم اشکالات فیزیکی داره میتونه انجام بده به وسیله ویس و خیلی خوبه که ما این برنامه ها رو داریم و من نمیدونم به فارسی هست یا نه فقط من باید بریم بیشتر تحقیق کنیم و بتونیم بدیم تو زبان های دیگه هستش Can we use any of this Brian in other languages?
In other language? Yeah, you can actually get Dragon naturally speaking for Spanish, French, German I think that's the couple, those are the few languages. Unfortunately, not available in Hebrew, Arabic, or Farsi at the moment, or Chinese for that matter. I know there's some talk about working a Chinese version of it because of the popularity in China, but the company has not. It cannot do multiple voices. That's a question that comes up a lot. Can I have two people speaking at the same time and will it record it, transcribe it on its screen, rather? It will not. However, if you have your own profile and you use a voice recorder, you can get a personal voice recorder and you can purchase from a store. You can record everything that you want to say and then connect it to Dragon and it will transcribe it. You need to get a voice recorder that's approved by Dragon. And by doing that, you can just buy the voice recorder and look at the package or at the store, look at the package and then see if it has the Dragon symbol logo on it. The Dragon symbol logo will look very similar to the logo on the screen is actually we don't see the screen here. If you can put up the other screen again. Thank you. Oh wait, the Dragon symbol looks like a little green, almost like a fire symbol. If you see that on the, it says you know it'll say like a proof for Dragon or supports Dragon. Then you may want to pick up the mic. The iPhone, iTouch, iPad. They have Dragon application, Dragon dictation, which you can dictate like you're dictating on this computer, but specifically for the eye devices. That sends information to the server, brings it back, and it dictates your email, your message, and so forth. They have another called Dragon a recorder, a voice recorder. What it can do is you can record what you're saying, connect the Dragon software, sorry, connect the iDevices to your Dragon software, and it'll transcribe it. So imagine being a voice recorder for your iDevices. But you need to have the version 11.5 version of Dragon for that to happen. So,
شنوندگان بینندگان میتونیم یه موزیک گوش بدیم، یه بریک کوتاه میگیریم و بعدا با شما خواهیم بود. یه برنامه فارسی یا چیز یه برنامه دیگه هستش، نرم افزاری هستش که میتونیم تکست بعدش اینکه موزیکی شنیدیم و اینا با شما خواهیم بود. فعلا تا چند لحظه دیگه با شما خواهیم بود.
Okay, so as Safar said, after the break we'll be covering a software called ZoomText. I mentioned ZoomText, the software that will that helps people with low vision to access their computer. So I'm going to go switch to the screen, IBC screen now. Okay, ZoomText is a magnifier. So think of a magnifying glass for your computer. This is the PC version of ZoomText. You can do several things. You could change the color. You could change the pointer size. You could change the cursor size, and where the focal point. You can have the ZoomText read everything to you, or some of the words to you, characters, letters, word. You can have it read. ZoomText for the web allows you to hear the web back to you while it's zooming the screen.
What's the difference between this and the other program?
Well, Dragon, actually speaking, is to help people who are having trouble writing, and then you can speak to the computer, and it'll write out.
Opposite of that.
This is more no, because this one is for people who have visual limitations. So this is to help them with limitation, to overcome that limitation. So right now I have it zoomed the screen at 1.25. So as you'll see, when I increase the font, we'll get this.
دوستان ببخشید یک اشکال تکنیکی به وجود اومد چون ما کامپیوترها و سافرهای خودمون آورده بودیم و اومدیم اینجا که بتونیم سوار کنیم یه اشکال تکنیکی وجود داشت و این کامپیوترها میدونیم بعضی موقعا نمیدونم تقصیر ماست یا تقصیر اونه فکر نمیکنم کامپیوتر اشتباه بکنه ولی وقتی میخوایم دو تا سیستم رو با هم را بندازیم و این برنامه‌ای که ما همش داریم خواهمش با ویس ها را بعد موقع چیز شناسایی نمی کنن از اینکه برنامه اینطوری شد و یکم اشکال تکنیکی به وجود اومد معذرت میخوام از آقای کامران میخوام این برنامه رو به وسیله سافری که این برنامه داره نشون بده و برای شما شرح بده که این زوم تکس چه کار میکنه. کامران can you please explain what the zoom text is and how it works.
Okay, I'm at the ZoomText website by a company called AI Squared, the company that produces software. So I'm going to play the video of the company's product called ZoomText 10.
Can you put
it
full screen?
Alright, so the ZoomText allows us to do several things. It also lets you see the background of the zooming of what your screen looks like. You can capture things from the web camera, you can have an audio, you can listen to the text of what's being read to you while it's zoomed. You can use portable devices like the iTouch iPhone to have things zoomed to you. So in this video is demonstrating how you can select your different options for your zoom text. Like, you can have background reader, it'll read anything that's playing in the background as you're going through your monitor. You can highlight text and have these highlighted texts read back to you. You can also zoom a very specific area of your screen and have it also read word by word or sentence by sentence. You can also record what you're listening to. So if you want to record any of the work that you wrote or produce, you can have it recorded to you and saved on an iPod or iTouch devices. Say if you want to read a book while you're traveling, you can have ZoomText record the text for you. You can also read applications as well. ZoomText will read applications such as Microsoft Word or any other application in the web browser, and it'll read that back to you as well. It's really versatile. You can also have ZoomText read section by section, but also will highlight as you're reading by creating a red box. You can have ZoomText pull, or you can have it in doc format, so you can zoom the entire screen or zoom certain parts of the screen while the other part of the screen is still what defined is not as zoomed. You could change the color scheme to black on white, white on black, multiple color schemes, yellow and black, for example, showing here, which will make it easier in the eye, because everyone has different type of eye conditions depending on your disability. And so the ZoomText will...
Some people are colorblind.
Some people are colorblind, that's right. And You can also get a camera bundle. This is a new feature, ZoomText. You can bundle it with a camera, and then you can zoom in certain features that you zoom in with the camera, and you can use it with ZoomText. That's a new feature that ZoomText offers. You can navigate through the different sections of a document by going next to previous, or highlight different sections of it as well. It's a very robust software, very much like Dragon. You got a lot of features, a lot of options. The best to call the company. The software is ranging between $300 and $600, depending which package you get. It is available for the PC. It is not available for the Mac. It's available for the PC. So Mac has their own Zoom tool. This is for the PC. So you can see the video, just taking you by different sections of it. So, yeah, that is the ZoomText in a nutshell.
دوستان از I think که تعامل ما را کردید و به ما گوش دادید و تماشا کردید این برنامه را خیلی متشکر هستیم. این برنامه با تمام ناتوانی های شینه که یکم هنوز مبتدیه و ما داریم سعی میکنیم بهتر بیاییم با تماس گرفتن شما، ایمیل فرستادن شما ما میتونیم بهتر انجام بدیم. خواهش میکنم اگر اشکالی میبینید، اگر دوست دارید ما بهتر کارمون انجام بدیم، اگر ایرادی هستش برای ما بفرستید. از تمام دوستان و آشنایان و تمام کسایی که ما را تحمل کردن و وقتشون رو تلف کردن و برنامه ما رو دیدن سپاسگزاریم. تا جلسه بعدی خداحافظ.
Anybody have any questions or that they want to share with us of the things that we covered? Just to sort of wrap up what we covered from the beginning, we talked about some different cane technology that we begin with. We talked about how cane, learning how to use a cane, and then going through some technology that can help somebody who is blind using a cane. Then we went on to talking about Dragon Naturally Speaking and that software, and if you have any questions about how speech recognition works, we talked about CapTel phone for the deaf and hard of hearing. If you want more information about CapTel, how you can get a phone that can caption what you're listening to. Then we talked about ZoomText. If you want to have any questions about how does ZoomText work, what can it zoom, what cannot zoom on a computer screen, and what can it say and what cannot say when you're zooming something. Yeah, I think that's in a nutshell. So if you have any questions, just give us a call or email us. We'll be more than happy to reach out to you. Our next show, we would like to cover how adaptive technology can help children with disability, and we will look at some products that can accommodate children with disability.
دوستان همونطوری که کامران شرح دادن، ما سعی میکنیم تکنولوژی جدیدتر بیاریم و سعی میکنیم برنامه رو بهتر از امروز اجرا کنیم. با تشکرات آقای سوری، با تمام این اشکالاتی که وجود داشت ما رو تحمل کردن و به ما کمک کردن، خیلی تشکر میکنم و تا روز بعدن خداحافظ.